The Cheyenne and Arapaho tribe of Oklahoma held its first ever Wi-Fi powwow last weekend. Thanks to a partnership with a broadband provider, the tribe was able to share their songs and dances all around the world. A clear sign that progress is being made in expanding high-speed internet in rural and tribal communities in Oklahoma. Jason Doyle joins us now with more details. Jason.
Rich, it's not just the Cheyenne and Arapaho tribes getting into the broadband action. Several tribal nations in Oklahoma are helping to connect their communities to others around our state.
And entry time. Please rise as we go into the grand entry here today for our 34th annual Oklahoma Internation Powwow Homecoming Celebration.
For more than 30 years now, the Cheyenne and Arapaho tribe has hosted the Oklahoma Indian Nations powwow.
We're still practicing our traditions and cultures, you know, our dances, our songs, everything. We're still here. Some people don't even, like big cities, you know, don't know we exist.
This year's powwow is different because it's wired for Wi-Fi.
The kids, I know they're all on their phones, but same with that. We still want them to get out and enjoy themselves in the arena, participate in our circles, you know, keep these traditions and cultures alive.
We have connected for the first time in history for the Cheyenne and Arapaho. We've connected all their grounds into a Wi-Fi mesh network to where everybody who's here has the ability to be connected to the internet.
Setting up a Wi-Fi internet mesh was the brainchild of the Cheyenne and Arapaho tribe and Chisholm Broadband's Senior Vice President of Business Development, Michelle Yurka.
It gives me goosebumps still to think about it and stuff, to actually see the bridge to the digital divide and to know that we facilitated that. You know, no matter where you live or your race or your culture or your economic status or however it is, we feel at Chisholm that everybody should be connected. So no matter where you're at.
Chisholm Broadband heard the idea from the tribe and decided to help free of charge.
This is something by the grace of my CEO and his pocketbook that he invested in. It's just something to give back to the community. It's definitely something that we're passionate about. No federal grant money was given for this, and this was definitely a donation that we did for them.
I want to welcome my brothers and sisters from Colorado, from Pine Ridge, South Dakota here. We got multiple states here with you tonight here.
One of those out-of-state guests is Miss Indian Arizona 2023-2024, Lainey Maria Lupe.
So Dago Desh, Shilani Lupi once said, Tishlagaisian and Deshli, Shamata Shitai. So that is the White Mountain Apache tribal language. I come from the Fort Apache Indian Reservation located in Arizona and a proud member of the White Mountain Apache tribe.
Well, she's the special guest for the Indian Nations powwow. She's also a full-time college student. So the Wi-Fi has allowed her to come to Concho while getting her academic work done.
I have been using the Wi-Fi. I'm actually a full-time student at Grand Canyon University, pursuing my master's in athletic training. So I just turned in a paper a while ago while I was in the car, all thanks to the Wi-Fi that they have here.
A little closer to home, Anadarko's own Eugene White Thunder Descendant Senior Princess 2023-2024, Kendall Hamilton, has been able to keep in touch with her sister as she's traveling out of state.
Yes, I've been communicating with my sister, Blue Sky Tosi. She's a Comanche Nation senior princess, excuse me. And she's making her way up to, I think it's Iowa, I believe. And she's sad that she's missing the powwow here, but I'm keeping her informed.
Hamilton has been able to share a win with her traveling sister.
I've been able to get videos of me dancing, boot and hat, because there was a special contest yesterday, and I champed out.
The device on this light pole is powering the Wi-Fi throughout the powwow grounds, allowing it to be streamed all over the globe by the tribe and those enjoying the powwow to stream the events to their family and friends, no matter where they're at.
What that device does is it propagates our internet signal to create Wi-Fi throughout all over. And so these propagate to each other, and so that's how we distribute Wi-Fi.
It took two crews, two full weeks, to wire the Cheyenne and Arapaho grounds in Concho. During the previous events on the grounds, vendors had to rely on a cell phone signal to process credit card or debit card payments.
Unfortunately, whenever you get these big events, everybody's trying to use their cell signal, so they're all going off one tower and they get kicked off and the priorities and things and it's overrun. And it's like going to an NFL game and you try to send something out on your phone. You just can't because the tower is bogged down.
While the Wi-Fi at the Cheyenne and Arapaho Powwow Grounds was a project put together by the tribe and a broadband provider, other tribes in Oklahoma are working with the federal government to connect more people in their area.
We're really excited about our Trace Fiber network.
The Chickasaw Nation recently received a $24.9 million grant from the U.S. Department of Agriculture to provide high-speed internet in Carter, Johnston, Murray, and Pontotoc counties. That money will help the tribe build out its current network.
Trace Fiber network really began in 2017. We made an initial investment from the nation to build out this network, and then we've been a recipient of this grant from USDA and also several other grants, including a total of about $78 million. So this $25 million was a big shot in the arm.
Bourne says that the Chickasaw Nation's initiative to connect more communities benefits more than just tribal citizens.
This impacts about 1,000 Chickasaw citizens, but it also impacts, several thousand Oklahomans in general. So it's a boon to, the mission of the Chickasaw Nation is to enhance the overall quality of life of the Chickasaw people, but it lifts up everyone.
Bourne says the expansion of broadband throughout the reservation will provide positive impacts for education, business, and health care. Cheyenne and Arapaho tribal legislator Kendricks Sleeper calls this year's Connected Powwow a success and feels it can help build a bridge between the younger members of the tribe and their culture.
You know, where you at all around here, that they were already trying to meet their friends, already on their phones, where y'all at, you know, so just happy to see them happy, to be able to communicate with everybody.
The Cheyenne and Arapaho tribe and the Chickasaw Nation are not alone when it comes to tribes wishing to expand broadband connectivity. The federal government's Tribal Broadband Connectivity Program has received more than 160 applications to share and nearly $3 billion in funding for broadband development.